to the National Indoor Arena and to the Battle of the Gladiators, one with a difference. The difference being that tonight all our contenders are all sporting stars in their own right.
Yes, five events, two go through to the Eliminator. The winner, £5,000. Runner-up, £2,000, which goes to a registered charity of the celebrity's choice. Not bad.
So let's meet our sporting celebrities. They are Denis, Andries.
And the big man, Gary Mason.
Hi, Denis, and welcome to Gladiators. Tell us a bit about your boxing achievements.
Well, I'm the only man in Great Britain to win the WBC light heavyweight title three times.
Fun tonight, or are you intending to take it very seriously?
I'm not here for fun. I'm not a fun guy. I'm here. This is serious. So we're out here to give the Gladiators a load of problems tonight. It won't be easy for them tonight.
Well, we're gonna watch out for you. Denis, Andries!
Gary. You're looking a bit hot. It looks like you've lost about a pound in sweat already. What have you been doing backstage?
Well, listen, I was walking about backstage and I thought I was a big guy, but I saw some of the gladiators and I started panicking. Look, sweat.
You're looking pretty hot. Gary, remind us a little bit some of your titles you won in boxing and what you've done.
I'm the former British heavyweight champion. I had a record of 36 fights, 35 wins, 32 by knockout. The only defeat was to Lennox Lewis. And at the time of the loss, I was ahead on all the judges' scorecards. So that was the end of me then, but it might not be the end of me in the future. In some of the papers today, I announced a comeback, and this have one fight, possibly Bruno, and then possibly Lewis, and give everybody some excitement for the future.
Wow, great stuff. So, we've got to ask you, Gary, are you taking it seriously? What are you doing on Gladiators then?
Well, this is my first time out. This is going to be my first training session. And what I want all you people to do out there is watch me, because I'm going to represent the people that watch Gladiators, think that they can do it, and go out there and try. I'm going to go out there and give it our best shot, because we're all gladiators in life.
Yeah. Off you go, Gary Mason.
And there's more. Will you please give a very warm welcome to Vinnie Jones.
And Oliver Skeete.
Vinnie, and welcome. Nice to see you're on time for once. Now, there's no two ways about it. You really are the naughty boy of football, aren't you?
Well, I do like to bend the rules every now and then, and sometimes it helps us to win, and sometimes we don't get nothing out of it, just a lot of problems.
Now, you're not going to stick to the rules tonight, then?
Probably not.
Well, you're obviously going to have to develop a very strong relationship with John Anderson, our referee. He'll be seeing a lot of you. Any one particular gladiator you're looking forward to meeting?
I've heard there's a little lad here called the Wolfman.
I haven't seen him yet. I think he's hiding in the toilets.
Oh, goodness. We'll certainly look forward to that confrontation. We'll see you a little bit later on. Vinnie Jones!
Oliver, tell us about yourself. How long have you been doing show jumping?
About 2 to 3 years, 2.5 years.
Tell us, how did a black Rastafarian get into show jumping? Are there any black Rastafarians in show jumping?
No, I'm the only one, and I'm proud of that fact. I got into... I got into show jumping through my two little girls. You know, I took them to the local riding school, and I had to stand there and watch them for a couple of months. Soon got bored doing that and had a go myself.
Great stuff. Tell us, are you taking gladiators seriously?
Like Denis said, we're not here for fun. Although I'm a fun person, tonight's very serious, because there's money involved for the kids of Romania and sickle cells and all sorts of things, so we're quite serious tonight.
Great stuff. Off you go, Oliver. Wish you all the best. Well done.
Now, will you please welcome our fifth sporting superstar. He is Neil Adams. Lovely to have you with us tonight.
Thank you.
Tell us about your judo achievement.
Well, I was world champion and I won 2 Olympic silver medals in Moscow and Los Angeles. And I've been 5 times champion of Europe as well.
So you're used to quite large competitions, aren't you?
Yes, I'm used to the big occasion, but nothing quite like this. But
it's a bit of a monster, isn't it?
It's a monster. And I mean, we've all been talking in the back there and we've decided that we're going to give these gladiators a run for their money today.
What a fabulous promise. Neil Adams.
Thank you.
And now it's time to meet our 6th sporting superstar, who is...
There's no one there, Ollie. I'm going to have some of the fun. Why not? 2 years I've been doing gladiators and I want some of the action.
You're going to take...
Yeah.
To know you quite well over the past couple of years, and I must say, we all know you as a footballer, but you're an incredible martial arts expert as well, aren't you?
Yes, I've been doing martial arts for quite a period of time now, and as you've seen me here, we've been doing quite a bit on each show. Every week when you see the shows, I like to do a little bit of warm-up with a few routines, that's it. So it's nice to be able to pit your wits against the best. I mean, some of these gladiators, I've seen them now for a long time. They are very, very good.
So your experience is going to come in quite handy.
Well, I hope so, Ollie. I hope so.
Now, listen, I'm not allowed to be biased in this, but I'll let you into a little secret. I'll be pitching for you, love.
Oh, thanks, Ollie. You're a darling. Thanks, Ollie. I'll need that.
John Fashanu.
Hold on!
This special charity event has raised £22,000 for the British Sports Association for the Disabled. And the winner tonight will be given £5,000 to give to a charity of their own choice and £2,000 to the runner-up. That's a massive £29,000 to charity. Now, we recorded our first event, Danger Zone, earlier. Here's some of the highlights of the hotshot action. Light heavyweight champion Denis Andries faced Panther. And he powered his way through to pick up 5 points. Heavyweight champ Gary Mason faced Zodiac, and despite his bulk, dived through that tunnel and used that knockout punch to pick up 5. Showjumper Oliver Skeete against Falcon. He put his rocket launcher to good use. Ba-boom! Fireworks for Falcon and 10 points for Oliver. Wimbledon soccer star Vinnie Jones faced Gladiators superstar Scorpio. And edited for 5. Our own favourite Fash was against Gladiator favourite Jet. Fash tonight representing Taekwondo. Not to be confused with Kwondo Kwondo, although this high-kicking routine from the pair of them resembled a bit of a dance. Fash onto the crossbow. Bullseye! Hits the target for 10. Looks more like bonfire night there than Christmas Day. Double Olympic judo medalist Neil Adam faced up to fellow Olympian Nightshade. Oh, and lit her up like a lampshade. Scores after the first event. Vinnie, Denis and Gary are on 5. Fash, Neil and Oliver all on 10. So sit back and enjoy the rest of the show as it happens. Event 2 is Powerball.
First up in Powerball, it's Denis and Gary. Protecting those baskets will be Wolf, Trojan, and Hunter.
Happy Christmas, baby.
Here comes the heavy mob to face the heavyweights.
Over to John Anderson.
And of course, these boxers used to wearing gum shields.
3, 2, 1.
Let's play ball. Here comes Gary. Straight into trouble there. Trojan takes down Denis. Gets up straight away, takes down Gary! Needs Hunter and his pal. It's Gary, and he's not having none of it. Oh, it's going in, I insist! But the gladiators seem a little standoffish with Gary, no wonder. 36 fights, 32 by KO. Be honest, would you want to get the measure of that heavyweight? Well, Hunter tried. There's Denis. A little underway for this. A couple of divisions lighter, but still a mean hombre. For 2, Denis for 2. And if you notice he's limping a little, that's from an earlier practice round. Doesn't seem to be stopping him. Oh, 2 to bring the big man down there. And Denis tries the old 1-2, that doesn't work. Gary running out of puff. good game, fellas. They gave it their all. Gary Mason hasn't fought since 1991 when he met Mr. Lennox Lewis. His only defeat, by the way, and he hasn't been in training since, so the boy done good.
Denis, that certainly was a tough one. A very physical game.
Yeah, well, I'm half crippled, but I'm still trying.
What was the matter with your leg? I saw you limping a bit there.
I practiced early today. I came down bad and landed my leg on my ankle and twisted.
Oh. Well, listen, you got 2 points.
Not bad for a cripple.
And Gary, what? Oh, goodness me. This is... This is turning into a wet T-shirt competition. Look, how did you find it?
Very, very hard.
It took two of them to get you down.
Well, they do this every day for months. I come here and do this once, and they deserve a lot of credit, because if they can do this every day, I'll put my hands up to them.
Well, they certainly do. Oh, that's very nice, but the credit has to go to you too, Gary. 6 points. Pleased with that?
Yes, very pleased, but still a long way to go, and it's getting harder.
All right, we'll see you later. Gary! Next up in the Powerball pitch, it's Vinnie and Oliver. And they're going to be facing Warrior, Saracen and Cobra. Over to John Anderson.
Contenders, ready!
There's our Vinnie. Oh, that's a promising start. Throws the ball at Saracen. Lost none of his charm, mind you. It was a good shot. After winding the Gladiators up, I bet he doesn't score either.
Let's get back to business again.
Referee John Anderson stamping his authority. Only Vinnie Jones would be stupid enough to offer out 60 stones of Gladiators.
Contenders, ready! Gladiators, ready!
Well, Vinnie, if he talks the talk, let's see if he's prepared to walk the walk.
3, 2, 1.
Let's play ball. It's time to put up or shut up. Shut up, Vinny. Look at that. What a cheek. The ball down the back of his pants. That's an old Meadowlark lemon trick from the Harlem Globetrotters, if you remember. Unfortunately, it doesn't work there for Oliver. In comes Vinny. Ready to Saracen and Warrior. Oliver, taken down. Vinnie into Saracen, no ball there, but plenty of action. No wonder they call him crazy from the crazy gang, but glad to have him with us. Oliver, faster foot and 2 points there. Straight in again goes Vinnie, and straight down. Looks like Saracen's bet might come off. No points yet for Vinnie. Come on, you two. Come on, 40 stone of Gladiators. I'm not mad. Oliver goes down. Oh, this is exciting stuff, folks. Wish it could go on for another 2 minutes, but there we are. Time up. That was good stuff, and Vinnie gets nothing. Saracen, I'll take your bet. Oh, bit of afters there.
So, at the end of that Powerball event, the scores stand as follows. Vinnie scored no points. Oliver picked up 2 points.
Well, you might think it a little unfair, 2-1-1 against Vinnie, but you've got to ask yourself who started it. And they say, don't start what you can't finish. Hello. Where's Vinnie off to? Oh, Vinnie Jones is taking on the Wolf. And Vinnie makes Wolf look like he came from the Lucy Clayton School of Deportment for Young Ladies. Look at this. They look like the Ugly Sisters. Oh, here comes Widow Twanky, Gary Mason, to break it up. It's a family show, folks. Yes, I must say. That's as near as you get to a handshake with these guys. I wonder if Vinny's playing in Panther this year. He'd make a great buttons, as long as they put them on his mouth.
Next up, it's Neil and Fash. unfortunately, they're facing Trojan, Hunter, and the Wolfman.
Contenders, ready! Gladiators, ready!
Well, I'm sure this game will be played with more of the sportsmanship that we've come to expect on Gladiators.
3, 2, 1!
Let's play ball! Oh, Fash, what a dummy! No wonder he's Wimbledon's pride and joy. Have you ever seen such a body swerve? He's so fast on his feet, look at that! Oh, he's so quick, no wonder he's won an FA Cup medal and 2 England caps. No wonder Wimbledon won't part with him, not even for £3 million. Oh, in he goes there, there's Neil Adams. And Neil should be at home here on the canvas match, being a judo world champion. 3 years in a row, I might add, as well. There goes Bash. Oh, boy, can he take a tumble. It's great to see the show's host out there. You wouldn't see Huey Green out there, would you? Or Bob Bunkhouse. 2-1 to Neil. I don't know, Bob might. Bash is down. Oh! Beautiful 2 points there from Neil. And Bash is down, he's not getting up. Something seems to be wrong. Is he winning? Well, I wonder what's up with Bash.
John, don't let him see you like that.
Well, Fash is not winded. It's something far worse. He's split his shorts. They'll be calling him John Fashanu next time. There he goes, 2 points there. Great speed from Fash. And John picks up a red ball. Well, he's certainly well famous for his ball control.
Neil, what can I say? That was most enjoyable to watch.
I'm glad it was enjoyable for some of you.
That's why I stand on the sidelines. You didn't enjoy it at all?
I did do. They were great lads. They're a bit too big.
Well, you'll be pleased to know you picked up 6 points. Oh. Well, John, my little star was all worried about you there, falling over. What happened?
Well, I exposed myself on a first degree. And I thought I'd better go down.
Indecent exposure.
Save myself my own being humiliated.
Well, you haven't been humiliated. You picked up 6 points.
Thanks, Ollie.
That's it for Fash and Neil.
Merry Christmas to everyone.
From the Powerball team.
Merry Christmas to you too, lads. Ho, ho, ho. And Fash wrapping up his presents for Christmas.
Fash! Smile! What's the matter? Are you hiding? You've got another guy, boy! They ripped it to pieces, didn't they, eh?
What a pantomime this show is turning out to be. We've had the Ugly Sisters, Widow Twanky, and now we've had Little John. After two events, Vinnie's on 5, Denis 7, Gary 11, Oliver 12, Fashion Neil leading with 16 points apiece. Over to Uli by the wall.
And standing at the foot of the wall, it's Denis! He's going to be chased by Lightning! Also awaiting the start of the wall, it's Gary. He's going to be followed by Zodiac. Over to John Anderson.
3, 2, 1.
Well, keeping the panto spirit alive, it's Jack and the Beanstalk, only this time the Giants are doing the climbing. Gary Mason's ambition is to establish arm wrestling as one of the great spectator sports in this country. And this wall requires more than arm strength, as you will see. Zodiac already on Gary's case. Got him by the knee. The coach doesn't go too high. Oh, Gary, hanging on with one arm there. He's down, he's off. Talk about Beauty and the Beast. There's Denis! Come on, Lightning! And Denis has given her the slip. That climb not affected by his ankle. 10 points for him.
not quite sure if you gave it your best shot. I think secretly wanted to be caught by Zodiac, didn't you?
No.
There was that weak and feeble look about you.
No. Make no mistake, I gave it my best shot. But they say that women are the weaker sex, but this is proof that they're not, are they, women?
Let's hear it. Let's hear it for Zodiac as well. So let's see how our next two superstars will get on. Standing at the foot of the wall, it's good old Vinnie Jones. And he's going to be chased by Jets. Also preparing for the wall, it's Oliver. Who's going to be chased by Scorpio. Over to John Anderson.
3, 2, 1.
And Oliver, used to getting over height, but usually with a horse between his legs. And talking to Vinnie has been described as talking to a brick wall.
Okay, this is not easy.
Vinnie, a Wimbledon player, but Oliver also a bit of a footballer, having played junior soccer for Luton and Fulham. Here come the girls. Will it be Jet that takes Vinnie down a peg or two? And she's on his case. But look at Oliver, what a terrific speed as he goes over the highest hurdle he's ever seen, and Vinnie's off the wall! We know that, he's definitely off the wall.
Last but not least, it's Neil! He's going to be pursued by Nightshade. And there's my little star, it's Fash! He's going to be chased by Falcon. Over to John Anderson.
3, 2, 1.
Well, let's hope Fash doesn't spit his shorts this time. It's going to be a tremendous few if he does. Oh, he's off the wall!
Go again, John. The wall moved.
He's going to have to get a move on now. He's being chased by Falcon, her first attempt on the wall. Being chased by fellow Olympian Nightshade.
Woo.
And look at the speed of this fella, considering he just slipped. And Nightshade on Neil already. And Fash is over for 10 points. Oh, Denis Andries there. Great impression of the Penguin out of Batman. And look at Nightshade ripping him off the wall there. Strong man, but not strong enough.
I needed that. Even though I fell down there, I was just about to have a cry. I got time to get back up again. Very pleased. I think I'll need those 10 points later on.
Well done, Nightshade.
Oh, thanks, Ollie. But I expect him to give me a really hard fight. Nothing, I wouldn't expect anything less from a fellow Olympian.
Oh, that's lovely. Let's hear it for Neil and Nightshade.
So the scores after three events, Vinnie static on 5, Gary 11, Neil 16, Denis 17, Oliver 22, Fash the Flash 26.
Well, welcome down to Oliver, Denis and Fash. You did a terrific job. Soon as the whistle went for you, Oliver, I saw you go faster.
I didn't fancy getting caught and pulled down that wall, I tell you. It was hard enough getting to the top.
What about you, Denis? Enjoy that one?
I really did enjoy that one, but I thought I was going to make it. It was real close.
And with a little bit of an injury. You really are my star, because I know in rehearsals you were saying you weren't too sure about the wall, but you did a good job.
Yeah, I was very worried about the wall.
What happened at the beginning there?
I slipped and I fell over and I was just about to have a tantrum, and I heard somebody shout, "Go again."
That's very unlike yourself.
Yeah, isn't it? Yeah.
And may I say, you've got very nice legs. It's the first time I've seen them in 2 years. They're lovely.
Thanks, Ollie.
While we catch our breath, you really must join us after the break here on the Battle of the Gladiators.
Welcome back to the National Indoor Arena, and like Cinderella, we're off to the ball, Atlaspheres. In this event, three contenders take on two gladiators. The three contenders are situated in the centre of the arena and will break to the pods on the referee's whistle. A special event for a special show.
And what's even more special our two gladiators are female. They are Lightning and Zodiac.
Check pod number one for smoke. Pod number two. Pod number three. Pod number four. Contenders ready!
Vinnie's in the black atmosphere. Denis in the red. And Gary's in the yellow.
Gladiators ready!
And as a special Christmas present in the commentary box with his tinsel, it's Trojan.
Whoa, hi there.
How you doing?
Not too bad, not too bad. Things are hotting up now.
Well, it's showtime out there. You've actually been in one of these atmospheres. What's it like?
Yeah, I did go Wembley. It's all lower body.
Ah, on three there. 3 points for Gary. And Vinnie there picking up three.
Pick up your legs and push like crazy. There you go.
Gary's a big fella, so he should find this quite easy. There's another 3 points for him. He seems to have blocked Denis out of it, actually. So what is the trick about this thing? Is it keeping those legs up high?
Yeah, lower body strength.
3 points
there. Don't worry
about
your arms. Oh, someone's down.
Denis is down there. He picks up 3 points, though.
Forget your arm, just go for the pods, and just try and ignore the fact there's gladiators chasing you.
Is this physically exerting?
It is a killer. It really is. A minute in this is like 45 minutes playing somewhere else.
Denis, 3 points there. And there's Gary on three. He's picked up 3 points there. Oh, Denis, go for it. 3 points. It's a high-scoring round there, and Vinnie doesn't seem to be doing much of it.
I think Vinnie's lost.
Yeah, what do you think of Vinnie?
He's a great guy, John.
Yeah. He's very popular with the gladiators.
That's right.
Look at Denis take a tumble there. That can hurt. Those cheese graters, pretty sharp.
Denis, I have to say, I'm very impressed. It's very rare that we get people go on Atlaspheres for the first time and score 9 points. How did you find it?
It's amazing. It's fun. I love this. This is a nice game. But I'm serious. I'm out here to take care of those gladiators. So let the beatings begin.
Whoa, let's hear it for Denis. Now, I want you to take this well. You scored 3 points.
Three?
That's very good, you know.
Yeah, on our golfers still now.
Well done, let's hear it for Vinnie Jones.
Well, I've never kept a goldfish in a cage. The water kept running out.
All right, Gary, leave the girls alone, for goodness sake. They've just been working very hard. You're all soaking wet again.
It's very hard, very competitive, and the two lovely gladiators. I would normally be chasing them, but unfortunately they were chasing me today.
Well, listen. They didn't do that good a job because you scored 12 points!
Awooga! Awooga!
There's Fash with his awooga! Do you know what that means, Trojan?
Well, it's what I say when Shadow hits me with a pugil stick.
Well, I actually asked him earlier what it means, and apparently it's Nigerian for joy and happiness. So we wish you an awooga Christmas, Fash.
This time our superstars are going to be facing Falcon and Panther!
Contenders, ready!
Oliver's in the black atmosphere, Neil in the red, and Fash in the yellow.
Gladiators, ready!
Is it any tougher for the girls out there, Trojan?
It is a bit, because they've got, like, less body weight, but, I mean, they're strong, they're tough. They're going to cause some damage.
Difficult, of course, because there's three atmospheres to roll up against. There's Neil Adams on one. Yes, 3 points. And Fash there, left of your screen, picks up 3 points.
Come on, girls. Good hit.
And make no mistake, this is tough stuff out there. In red, Neil there for 3 points. On two, Oliver. Some high scoring going on. This herd difficult to round up. There's Neil with another three there. Oh, ba-boom! There's Fash making a dash. Oh, 3 points there. You'll be meeting Fash in just a while, won't you?
I'm going to get him on the Duel, yeah.
How do you think you're going to do?
Oh, I'll take him apart. Easy.
Well, we'll look forward to seeing that. Tremendous energy there from Fash. 3 points. He goes through the spoke.
Oh, good hit.
Oh, great hit.
Yeah, the contenders did well there.
Yes, they did. And you better get ready for the next event.
I have indeed. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas, Trojan. Let's look at Oliver. He had the opportunity to score, but never quite centered his Atlasphere.
Now, Atlaspheres. First of all, what did you think?
That's the hardest one out of the lot. I wasn't really expecting to go too far with this, and I don't think I scored any.
Well, you did. You scored 3 points.
Thank you very much.
As a rule, I never chase guys, but these are kids.
Highest scorer, 12 points.
Oh! Thank you.
Oh, careful, Fash, or you'll split them again.
What can I say? You did very well, my little star.
What was the score? What did I get, Ollie? Tell me.
What do you think you got?
I thought I got 12.
Oh, you got 9. That's not
bad. Yes.
Pleased with that?
I'm very pleased with that.
I saw a certain little person giving you a bit of trouble, this madam here.
He's been practicing,
She was psyching me out.
That's why he keeps reading these lines from his pocket. He's got paper in his pocket. He's not actually learning his lines at night. He's coming here and taking the Atlaspheres and practicing.
I'm pleased with those points. Thanks, Ollie.
Well done, Fash. And let's hear it for our gladiators, Falcon and Panther.
After 4 events, Vinnie moves to 8, yet to get into a double figures. Gary's on 23, Oliver 25, Denis 1 point ahead on 26, Neil's on 28, and Fash still in the lead, extending to 35.
Our next event is Duel, and first up, it's Oliver! And he's facing Hunter!
And we asked Oliver earlier today if any of the gladiators worried him.
The only gladiator that really worries me is Shadow, and it's not his size, it's just his eyes. He tries to hypnotise people just before the contest, and that's what puts people off, but he's not going to do that to me.
On guard!
He can set his mind at rest. He's facing the rookie Hunter, but he'd still better protect himself because this lad learnt a lot over the past 14 weeks.
3, 2, 1!
Oh! 4 faults for a refusal there. The show jumper did the jump without his horse. Oliver expecting the one that came from behind, but not the one that hit him full in the face. He's used to being clocked, but not like that.
He caught me right at the top of the head.
Yeah, we spoke about
that the first one, didn't I?
Yeah.
You the first one. I was waiting for it.
You
I was
going to
duck it, right? And they shoved me in the face a bit.
Yeah.
Oliver passing on the benefit of his experience there. Oh, and Vinnie Jones putting in his tuppence worth. No stranger to conflict himself.
Next up in Duel, it's my star. It's Fash! He's up against Trojan!
We asked Fash if he was going to be nervous this evening.
Well, you know, I'd be lying if I said I wasn't going to be nervous. I would get very nervous. But I mean, we talk about nerves, I've got a funny story on nerves. I mean, when we did the first series last year, you know, I had a little sort of cascade of whiskey, and I hate whiskey, but I brought it along. A little of football is what you do, is you have a little sip before you go on. It just warms you up, gets rid of the nervous energy, and, you know, you get on there. So I said to Ollie, Erika, I said, I could see she was very nervous. And I said, Ollie, look, just have a little sip of that. It'll warm you up, love, make you feel good, get rid of the nerves. I said, I'm as nervous as you are. She had a little sip, and I had a little sip, and I said, I'm just going to put it behind here, the ledge, behind the back of the stage. Before we go on, we'll have a little sip again, and we'll just go out holding hands, and it'll be great. So when I looked over from the other side of the stage, I could see her ears were glowing nice and red, and her face and her cheeks. I could see she looked so relaxed, everything was funny. So I thought, I better, just as we're going on stage, I thought I'd better get to the little cascade and have a drink. When I got to it, she'd drunk the whole lot. It had gone. So I had to go on stage, absolutely dry, really nervous, and I kept looking at her, smiling and laughing. I thought, you got it, girl, you got it.
Great story there from Fash. Don't forget, Trojan Thomas is going to take Fash apart. Let's watch this one. Oh, some good ducking and diving from Fash. And a bit of blocking there, Trojan doing all the work. Those mad eyes of Shadows. Oh, Oh, it's an uppercut from Bash, and Trojan takes a dive. Well, I hope Trojan doesn't come back in the box. Look at this, high and low work, and it's just one uppercut, and that is enough to send Trojan packing. Good night, Vienna. And Fash there with his contender Christmas club.
Yes, for you, man. That's
yeah,
for you.
For me. Nice.
For you.
Next up in Duel, it's Neil. And he's up against the one and only Saracen.
Neil Adams, the current national judo coach, we asked him if judo would help him this evening.
Well, it does help because we need all over strength. I mean, it's legs, it's arms, it's cardiovascular conditioning and muscular endurance. So it's a bit of everything, really. So I suppose that it tends to make us a little bit more agile and able to cope with, you know, what we need here. But I just want to have a bit of fun with it as well. But obviously, we'll all be going for it.
3, 2, 1.
So have a time for Neil. Look at Saracen. Looks like he's doing a bit of planting there. And it's all on Neil. Oh! Judo helps you balance until you run out of floor. Cue those glad hands. Next up, it's Vinnie Jones.
Wide grip. Wide grip, man.
Fash giving him the benefit of his knowledge. This is one of the contests we've all been waiting for. Vinny versus Wolf. I asked Vinny what he'd be thinking about when he gets up there.
I'm not going to be thinking a lot. I'm just going to be thinking how to do my victory salute. I think that's the first thing that's going to come into my head. If he's going to start staring me out, I'm going to look into his eyes, because that's when you can really tell a lot about somebody. So like when they're getting these Muppets off the street down here and taking them on, but they're taking us on. And we're a little bit fit. And my game's running all over the place on a football pitch, and so I've got plenty of stamina, and I hope he's got some as well.
Next up in Duel, it's Vinnie Jones.
And you may know the game Mortal Kombat. This is going to be very close.
And he's finally met his match in the Wolfman.
Boy, where do you put your money?
Over to John Anderson.
Contender ready! Gladiator ready! On guard!
Well, there was some argy-bargy between the pair of them earlier. Now it's time to settle the score.
3, 2, 1!
Time to put up or shut up. This is going to be terrific. And Wolf, the aggressor straight away. And Vinnie hasn't made a move. Just frozen there. Come on, Vinny, let's see what you're made of. Pokes Wolf in the face. And Wolf having at him low and high. He's determined to get Vinny off. Yes! That's one for the Gladiators. Sorry, a little biased there, but I've got to put my cards on the table and say yes, sirree. Over at the Christmas club, I'm sure Vinny's got an opinion.
Really try and get you. Tap them in.
But in there, you've just got to stay on, haven't you?
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, no, I've got this kind of
the one on the head, Gaz.
Must have blocked them in.
Yeah. Boom. Yeah. Gaz, if they hit your head, you're all over the place.
Yeah.
All you hear is bang, when you're all over the place. Try and stay there.
When you line up.
Next up, ready to do battle, it's Denis. And he's going to be facing Warrior.
Denis, of course, undefeated as British light heavyweight champion, and like most boxers, he had predictions. This is what it was.
I'm going to smash Warrior. He's going to be put to rest.
3, 2, 1.
There's no rest up there when you take on Warrior. Oh, rest in peace yourself. Well, thank goodness fighters stick to boxing and not fortune-telling. Oh, let's check this replay out. Denis backs off. Nowhere to go. Nowhere to run.
Well, this is the one you've all been waiting for. The battle of the heavyweights. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Gary Mason.
Undefeated British heavyweight champion between 89 and 91.
And Shadow.
Undefeated dual champion since 1992. Gary, as I said earlier, hasn't been in training for a number of years, but happy to join us for the special event.
Well, I feel privileged to represent the people out there that sit at home and watch television, just like what I did, sit at home, watch the Gladiators and criticise the Gladiators or the performers on it, saying, well, I can do that, or he should have done better, and Cora, isn't she slow, or isn't he slow? You know, so I've come along to represent them. I've come along, I've just come straight, literally, straight off the street, got involved, so watch me, watch yourself.
3, 2, 1!
Let's get ready to rumble! Oh, Gary steps across, disqualified. Shadow's down, but he's not out.
The result of that contest was a win to the Gladiator because of the push. However, because we are all interested in a good competition, it will be refought. It is not permitted for either the Gladiator or the contender to step across or put a hand across. They must stay on their own podium. 3, 2, 1!
A rematch means if Gary wins, he'll only pick up 5 points, having lost the first duel. And there's Shadow. What a good lick. Oh, he sways back, and Shadow puts his hand across. He's disqualified. Gary doesn't realise it. And as John Addison said earlier, you can't touch the other podium, but great sportsmanship. And the Christmas Club delighted. Shadow wins the first, Gary takes the second. It's a draw, 5 points to Gary. So the final scores, Vinnie 8, and I feel the Gladiators had something to do with that. Oliver 25, Denis 26, Gary and Neil both on 28, and Fash with a convincing 45. Remember, these are professional sportsmen who've given their time and effort free of charge for some very worthy charities. So join us after the break for the answer to our competition and a real Christmas cracker, the Eliminator. Welcome back to the National Indoor Arena, where we must first congratulate our winner, who successfully guessed that this little flower would blossom into the deadly nightshade. Let's hear some more about her from the lady herself.
I was born in Jamaica, 1960. I'm one of seven children. I have three brothers and three sisters. And I moved with my mum to Britain in 1961. So I really don't know Jamaica at all, but I'm looking forward to going back because my parents are retiring there soon. I think the first competitive sport that I really fell in love with was athletics. I started doing the hurdles and the high jump, and I really liked that. But I was a sort of scatty brain type of child, and so if they'd asked me to do just one event, I would have got bored. So I discovered that there was an event in athletics called Doing Everything, and that event was called Pentathlon, which was subsequently changed to the Heptathlon. And so I've always been a multi-eventer. I like to do lots of different athletic events. When I was 16, I got my first international vest and I competed for Great Britain. I just didn't believe it. It was fantastic. I loved that. And after that, I went to my first Olympics in 1980 in Moscow. Then I went to Los Angeles in 84, and I went to Seoul in 88. I came fifth in the 1984 Olympics in Los Angeles. And I hold the British record for the heptathlon at 6,623 points. And I have Commonwealth gold, silver and bronze medals from the three Commonwealth Games I've been to. And it's just been fantastic. I love it that you all sit and watch Gladiators. But every so often, I want you to get off that sofa and do something active. Get fit. It's real fun.
Now then, Gary, at the end of the duel, the referee decided that because Shadow won the first one, you won the second one, it was a draw. He then gave you 5 points, which put you on par with Neil here. Now, points-wise, you're not going to take part in the Eliminator. Why is that?
Well, I've got a little bit of an injury. It's not bad enough to exactly stop me from taking part, but because it's close and I feel Neil's the better man for this job, we're giving Neil the job, and I'm going to be his coach for this one.
Oh, that's lovely. That's lovely. Now, Neil, how do you feel about all this?
Well, it's down to a team effort, so Gary and I decided. He's my coach,
where he was up until you just asked him for the same.
Oh my goodness, yes, it's got to be fair. Now, Fash, how many times have we not stood at the other end of the Eliminator and bitten our nails and nearly had heart attacks over here? How does it feel to be standing here about to take part?
It's very nervous. You don't believe how nervous it is, you know. I think we're all being used to being in front of crowds and, you know, live shows or things like that, but it's very, very nerve-wracking. And we're just trying to settle yourself down, especially when you know somebody like Neil, he's very, very quick. You've got him following you.
Certainly is. Well, best of luck. You've been very
Sorry,
good.
Can I just say,
yes,
can I hope that when these two go, that everybody gets behind the two of them, because they're both racing for charity. It's not one against the other. It's both for charity. So let's give them a big boost right the way around.
Thank you, Gary.
So Fash leads by 17 points, which gives him a head start of 8.5 seconds. But I must tell you that Neil has been exceptionally fast over this Eliminator course in practice, so it ain't over yet.
John, you will go on my first whistle. Neil, you will go on my second whistle. 3, 2, 1.
And look how John psychs himself up. 8.5 seconds, but he knows what's ahead of him. Living hell. World champion. Oh, what's happened to Fash? He's got a problem there with his gloves or something. Fash, you can't afford to waste this time. What on earth is he doing? And Neil is now in the lead. And he's on the overhead ladder. For this special celebrity eliminator, no handbikes. There comes Fash. He's somehow catching him up. Oh, he's dropped. Neil's down. That's a 10-second penalty. And Fash is wobbling. Oh, he's only just made it. The cargo net. I'm dying to know what was wrong with that glove. All right, John's let him go. There goes Neil. And he's got some way to go. Neil Adams, as we said in practice, very fast over the Eliminator, but John Fashanu down the zip line. A footballer, his balance should be excellent. And he's got Neil on his tail. Oh, what a bad ball! And now, as a footballer, he should have the legs. And Neil's lost his legs. Come on, Fash, pump it up there. Oh, what's he doing? He's going backwards. Come on, Fash. He grabs the rope. Oh, my God, he's slipping. Oh, the legs are gone, but Geronimo, well done, Johnny. £5,000 to charity. And here comes Neil Adams, world champion, judo champion, runner-up, £2,000 to charity. Tonight has raised £29,000.
Well, Fash, that was incredible to have my co-presenter come through the line and win £5,000 for charity. Which charity it's going to?
There's a lot of charities out there who need it, but the two I've picked, I'm splitting it, is sickle cell, which is a black disorder, affects men, women, children, and also Bernardo's, coming from a Bernardo home myself. So a lot of kids out there, the Bernardo boys.
That's lovely, that's lovely. You enjoy it?
I enjoyed it, it was good fun. I enjoyed it.
Neil?
Yes?
£2,000 to charity for you too, where's yes. it going?
Well, what we're going to do, Gary and I are actually going to split the money. Gary's is for shelters, and mine is for spinal injuries.
Oh, that's terrific. Well done, let's hear it for our two superstars, Neil and John.
Merry Christmas to all you Gladiator fans. See you for the grand final next week. Don't miss it.
It was the question we were all left pondering on Saturday nights in the 90s. Do you feel the power of the Gladiators? Well, I hope you do, because there's more on the way next. New to challenge? Whilst over on pick, it's border security, Australia's front line.
Do not attempt to recreate any of the events you have seen on Gladiators. Both contenders and gladiators have been trained for this competition, and safety equipment is mandatory. The Gladiators.